Hi, I'm Deepak, and also with me here are my colleagues Sheetal and Himanshu. So for the past few months, our team has been working very, very hard and but passionately on building India's first connected car system, which is CarIQ. So a car buyer scenario. So this is how, here's a little story. So a car buyer right now, he has access to so much of information, both online, offline, and reviews from friends, that the car buying decision has already been done. So before he actually makes, he goes to the dealer, the sale is already done. So he has so much of information. But what happens after the purchase? After the purchase, he again goes back to a dark age where he has absolutely no access to information. So it is like the fable of the six blind men and the elephant, where everyone has very vague idea about what's happening. So similarly, I mean, he has no idea about how he's driving, when is the warranty due, when is the next service due, how much is it cost for the servicing, and he has no idea about the condition of the car. So now with CarIQ, you can monitor, manage, and interact with your car. The device is always connected, and your car is always connected to the cloud. And we do a whole lot of analytics on this data, and then we can give you valid inputs on taking actions, actionable points right back to you, so that you can have a lot more. Lot more actions about the car. Now, CarIQ is a smart plug-and-play device. We've made it so minimal and so simple that it's this small. It's a plug-and-play device. You just plug it into your car and forget all about it. So it is so simple and minimalistic that even a 10-year-old neighbor can easily fit it for you. So now, once connected, your now smart car can connect to your home, your workshop, share stuff on social media, connect to the other cars, give location information, and in the future give breakdown assistance provisions, and even give a lot of alerts. So now at CarIQ, we focus on building the entire platform which connects all the ecosystem players. So if you want, you can share, if you choose to, you can share this information with insurance insurance providers, who can give you a very good rebate on your premiums. If you can choose to share it with your infrastructure planners, who can help you in your town planning, and even with your workshops. So imagine you're going on a trip to Goa, and your workshop actually calls you and then tells you that your car is actually ready and good to go without you having to actually take the car to the workshop. So this is a completely in-house built product, but it's ready for the world. So all the components that we use are standard and tested across the globe. So it's standard. So looking at the market size, we have a very strong market size. India has around 3 crore cars plying on the road as of now. And from that, we support all cars after 2008, making our addressable market size around 1.5 crore cars. And also close to 22 lakh cars are added every single year. Now, yes, there is competition, but there are players like Automatic, Zubi, and Mojo, all heavily funded, and their primary market is always Canada and USA, and they're not looking at the Indian space at all. Also, we are providing the whole platform and the ecosystem, not just the product. So our main challenge is definitely, it's a new market. India is not, hasn't heard of such a product yet. So this is definitely a new market, and that is one of our biggest challenges right now. So behind every challenge, there's a great team. So some fun facts about our team is that our average age is just 29 years. Every single person in this team has taken a huge hit to come on board. And the collective experience is around 75 plus years. And we have people from across the spectrum. We have people with experience in product management, embedded hardware, sales support, automobile enthusiasts. So on the right hand side, you can see our sexy UI. So this is the current state of our product. So a couple of months back, 2 months back, we had opened up our site for pre-orders, and we within 2 months and zero marketing, we have reached 150 plus pre-orders, which will be shipping this month. And we have data from more than 300 cars, which will be used as a benchmark for analytics. And we are also seeing a lot of interest from international markets. So while all the big players are actually trying to bring internet into your car, we focus on bringing connecting your car to the internet. Thank you.
Thank you.
Twitter handle so I can follow you back.
Can you just quickly talk about two or three of your top use cases?
Top use cases, okay. So imagine you're on a trip, you're going from Mumbai to Pune, and your car just breaks down in midway. So even for even to tell a pizza delivery guy where exactly you are located, it's such a pain in the ass. So but we have your location information and what exactly is wrong with your car. So we can send you breakdown assistance to your exact location, and he'll also have a spare part with him to fix your car. Then, you can.
How will you know that the car is broken down and I've not just stopped, and what exactly is broken in the car?
Because we read data directly from the engine. So if there's any problem with the engine, we'll definitely know that because it'll come up as an error code in the engine. So our system directly reads data from this engine and posts that to the cloud.
So first of all, this is all standard stuff, right? You use an onboard diagnostics port.
Correct.
Everybody has. You
yes,
use the standard, formats and the standard interfaces and standard languages everybody does.
Mm-hmm.
I can get this from a portal in China for like $5 or $10 or $20, right?
Yes, but that...
Hold on. So
yes.
You're not building the hardware. It's standard hardware that you're getting from China or somewhere. Mm-hmm. What's the big deal? What is it that you're doing here?
So
this is standard stuff that's there in every car that anybody can buy off the shelf anywhere in the world.
Yes.
What are you doing?
Yeah, so the Chinese models, they are usually Bluetooth. So it doesn't work unless you are in the car. It's not a connected car solution. You have to be in the car to read data from it. This is a completely...
So basically, you got a SIM card in this.
Yes, we
got
do.
It. So, but it's still a standard device that you don't manufacture that everybody around the world has. What's the big deal about you guys? What are you doing here?
We're building the platform, which will help connect all the ecosystem.
So let's talk
players.
About that, right? So when you say that you're building a platform to connect all of this,
yeah,
you know, what is it? Is it like a dating network for cars? My car's likes your car. What is it? I mean, I want to figure out, what is it the actual use case? Because what you talked about there, actually, I can do on my GPS phone. The question that Anupam asked.
Mm-hmm.
I want to specifically, I mean, I think when you say platform, I get scared. It means I don't know what, it means another way of saying I don't know what I really want to do,
mm-hmm.
right? What is really the thing that I'm going to pay money for here? Because a standard device, I can buy it for $20, $30. I don't know, maybe you sell it for $50, $100, whatever it is.
Yeah.
You make some money on the device.
Mm-hmm.
But I can buy this. Anybody can import these devices en masse in hundreds of thousands,
mm-hmm.
and you'll be washed out of the market.
Mm-hmm.
Why should I buy from you?
It's just because of the platform which we're building.
What does the platform do for me?
The platform, it gives you a lot of value addition.
What?
Breakdown assistance.
But that I can get from really, you know, it's not a big deal, right?
See, breakdown assistance every car manufacturer now provides,
yeah.
right?
It's
so there's nothing really additional that you provide.
It's there, I mean, it's there on the sticker on the inside of the car, there's a number that you call when you're broken down and the guy figures out where you are.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like he needs my latitude and longitude. You say, boss, I'm somewhere between mile number 45 and 46 on this highway, he'll come and do it. I mean, it's not a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
So what is really this platform value addition that you're doing?
Can find out problems with your car. I mean, it reads data directly.
Every
from the
such
car.
Device does that.
Excuse me?
Yeah, every
yeah,
device
yeah,
that
yeah,
does.
The Bluetooth
what do
versions.
You do that is different?
It's mainly the platform.
I think that's just elaborating on that. What I didn't get.
Yes.
See, whenever you list a slide which
yeah.
has 6 points,
mm-hmm.
I was watching your slide on the benefits.
Yeah.
Right? I think it was slide number 2 or 3.
Mm-hmm.
At 6, you've lost me.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me one guy who makes a decision based on 6 points. You make a decision based on 1 point.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. So if you think, and I'm going with what you were saying, if you think breakdown is your point,
mm-hmm.
then that's all there is.
Mm-hmm.
Now the fact, as Anupam was pointing, you will be competing, there are breakdown players in every city, which I'm sure you're aware,
yeah.
including Pune and Bombay.
Yeah.
Right, and they sell those cards and you can call a number and they'll send a crane to pick it up. So that's okay. So you're going to compete with them. That's fine, but that's not a problem. But the key is that where you lost my attention was 6 points. You cannot sell a product which has 6 benefits. It basically means you have no benefit, right? Either you go and pick one benefit and say, boss, this is it, everything else is supplementary, right? When you eat food, you have one chal, dawal, and then everything else is sabzi and all is nobody cares.
Yeah.
Right. So that's the main ingredient I couldn't get. Right. So if you bring the main ingredient forward, and everything else is raita and you know the rest, achar.
You know, I'll try to put a different spin on it. If you're able to take this, all the aggregated data that is there from all of these hundreds of thousands, if you're able to then give me some stuff saying, for your car model, compared to all the other car models, your engine is 25% more efficient, 33% more greasy, 20% closer to, you know, if you allow me to benchmark something, then there's a value in a network.
Yeah.
There's no value in a network when you say breakdown assistance, because frankly, I don't need a network or to use that word platform to offer breakdown assistance.
Yeah.
So my only suggestion to you is dig deeper, figure out really what is the value to the driver and the owner from being part of this network where my data goes up, right?
Yeah.
And then I think you may have something, because otherwise you're going to get washed out by the people who will sell the product at 1/5 the price of yours, because you know it's an effort for somebody to say, you know, why they should belong to your network and why they should download the app.
Hmm.
Yeah, that's just 2 cents.
One or two questions.
Yes.
How does it connect to the car?
Every car has a port which is called the OBD port, and by law it's required that it be within 2 meters of the steering wheel.
Okay.
So every car after 1986 actually has it.
Really? Okay. And so you were saying you're a platform.
Yeah.
So I just take that to mean that you're providing a number of services.
Yeah.
What are the charges for these services?
Excuse me?
What are the charges for the services?
Oh, the services? No, we don't do services. It's
so,
just that
so you're just selling the device.
Yeah.
And everything else is then complementary.
I didn't get what are you saying about the service? Oh, the service. Okay. So right now we just it's free for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
So we are trying to partner with ecosystem players so that we can bring the charge down after that.
Okay.
So it's free for 2 years.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.